The t-test, how we can do with the Excel. You can open the, there's a t-test. Kindly open the, there's a lot of sheets are available in the survey, experimental, descriptive. Then you can open a t-test. Please, I request all to open the t-test. You are seeing the male and female, no? You are seeing the male and female data. So you are seeing the male and female data. Yes, okay. Now, can we do a t-test? I'm going to do a t-test. Which t-test more apt here? Anyone can tell? There is a two groups, male and female.
Independent sample details.
Yeah, there is a two groups, male and female. Then what is the mark? Achievement mark, like that I'm taking. So here, what is independent variable? What is the independent variable? Yeah, gender is independent variable because the gender may influence, may give the effect on the achievement score. Therefore, achievement is the dependent. So what is the thumb rule to do a t-test for independent sample t-test? What is the thumb rule? The independent variable should be, independent variable should be, IV should be, should be, independent variable should be what? Anyone? Categorical. Dependent variable should be?
Continuous.
So in this independent variable also categorical you are telling, no? The categorical, how many classifications? How many classifications? Only two. The continuous two. Variable, not a total issue. So the classification only two. So this is a basic assumption for doing a independent sample t-test. You got clear? So the next thing, the independent sample t-test is two groups, only one test. So if you are going with the two sample groups differ. Sample group is two groups, test is one. So you are going to test only one test or one score with the two groups, then you can go with independent sample. These things you know. Just I'm going to do a SP through the Excel. See here. Where we can go, what is the path to do a data analysis? Go with the data. Go with the data, then where we can go. So
data analysis.
Pardon, the right side is the data analysis. Click the data analysis. Kindly check what is the statistics very apt here. What is the statistics very apt here?
T-test.
Whether we can go with unequal, so both is same only. So yesterday Sarge talking about the Levenge t-test, no? So in the Levenge test only it's checking the homogeneity. So I'm adopting the unequal variance, t-test of two samples assuming unequal variance. It means that the two variants are not at all same, like that I'm making the assumptions. I'm clicking OK. Please, I request all to click the t-test two sample assuming unequal. Once you click it OK, you are getting the options. Whatever input variable, anyone can tell, variable two is coming. What is, which variable you may treat it as a variable one? Anyone can tell? Which variable may treat it as a variable one?
Female.
Male.
Yeah. So what do you have to do?
Alphabetically, B2.
Yeah. So I'm not making a say one, two as a male and female here. For doing a SP Excel strategy, you have to keep the male separately, female separately. Then only you may get it very easily. The variable one is a male achievement score is a variable one. Therefore, what I'm going to do, keep the cursor here. Kindly check whether the cursor is blinking in the variable one. Then after this, select the variable, select the male only. Now you are seeing the B1 to B16. B1 to B16. Then next variable two. What is my variable two? Any idea?
Female.
So I'm selecting the female. It's over. So hypothesis mean difference, we are not checking the with hypothesis mean difference because we are going to check the mean differences directly here. We are not fixing any height of hypothesis mean difference from the male to female, how much mean difference. We are not fixing anything. The next thing, can we fix the label? Why I have to fix the label? Any idea? Why I'm fixing the label?
Level of significance.
No, sir. Actually, we are already choosing the term cell containing word male and female.
Yeah, exactly. It's correct. They will be correct. Because we are selecting the male also. The first column, the male heading, and the second column, female heading also be selected. That's why we have to select the labels. Then the alpha value is nothing but level of significance. I'm fixing 0.05, right? Then the output range, I'm going to, I'm going to execute the results. Therefore, I'm clicking the output range. Keep the cursor somewhere. So I'm keeping the cursor in the K11. You can keep it anywhere. Kindly check whether the output is showing you, the output number that cell is showing you. After checking this one, click OK. Click OK. Kindly check whether you are getting the report. Kindly check whether you are getting the output. Can you see the output? How many are getting this output? So those are getting the output, kindly type in the, yeah, very good, good. Manish Kumar, good. So Cam and I, good. Smita is late. Everybody is good. Sandhya is good. Yes, Jyoti is correct. So it's so happy to see this one. Yes, now see the interpretations. What is the mean score of male? 47, female is 62. The variance, so if you have the variance, you can easily to find out the standard deviation, because if you square root, you may get standard deviation also. This was female, this for the observation, male 15, female is 20. See Vandana, kindly select the output properly. Okay, if you are not select the output properly, make an issue. Once again, I will demonstrate after this. I am giving the interpretations. And now, yesterday, some people are asking the questions about the one-tailed test, two-tailed test. Anyone having the idea what is the one-tailed test, two-tailed test? Any idea? Hello?
Directional hypothesis, then we use
mental test. So, Sanjana, kindly tell. Others kindly mute. Sanjana, this time I will mute.
Sir, can I?
Yes, Sanjana, please. Sanjana, please. Okay, then otherwise, Sandhya, kindly unmute and talk to me.
Sir, for directional hypothesis, we use one tail.
Exactly.
And for non-directional, we use two tail.
Exactly. This is only the understanding. Okay, what is the directional? If you are talking about male is better than the female is better than the male. Like that, if you are assuming as an hypothesis, then it's called directional hypothesis. But normally, we are taking the consideration only for the, what is this? Null hypothesis only. Therefore, null hypothesis may be treated as a directional hypothesis. Even which are things come to this are non-directional? Which are things come to the non-directional? Any idea? Whether alternative hypothesis may come to the two type? Alternate hypothesis?
Yes, sir.
Exactly. Because for example, I'm taking the null hypothesis. There is no significant difference between male and female of academic achievement, on academic achievement. So this is called null hypothesis. What is the alternative form? There is a significant. Here also we cannot find the direction. Therefore, when you go for the non-directional hypothesis, you can take the consideration as a two-tailed test. When you're taking the directional hypothesis, you can take consideration only the one-tailed test. But I am taking the two-tailed test only, because I am selecting there's a hypothesis I'm going to test. There is a significant difference between there's a significant difference in the mean scores of male and female in the academic achievement. That is my but it is the null hypothesis. Now what I'm going to do, see where which things I may take, whether I can take one tail or two tail if I'm taking the null hypothesis. Anyone can tell? If taking the consideration, I'm asking I'm taking the null hypothesis.
Two tail.
Yeah, so therefore I can take the p-value of two tail, p-value of the t. So I'm taking only the two tail p-value. What is the p-value?
0.01.
Therefore, what it means? It's less than the 0.05. Therefore, what it means? What it means? It is significant or not significant? It is significant or not significant?
Significant.
Yeah, exactly. Therefore, the null hypothesis to be rejected. So, I request all to mute, please. Because there is a echo. 1 minute, I can do the demonstration with the one. Okay. Yes, the people yesterday, you are asking a lot of queries to SAS, how it should be significant, non significant. For that, just I'm doing one small demonstration. Please. I'm opening my camera. So I hopefully you are seeing me. So now the camera is open, please. Camera is open. Yeah, so my screen is visible to all of you.
Yes, sir.
Yes, there is a problem at all the people's. Okay, see here. I'm going to compare with some kind of example. See, this is my p-value. Kindly see the p-value. This is my botanist p-value. So p-value is represent one thing. I mean, reduce the blur, otherwise you cannot see my screen properly. I am turn off the blur. Now you are seeing me properly. Yes. This is my p-value. So this p-value is 0.05, like 500 ml. I am taking the consideration p-value. Okay. Now see here, this is another bottle. Otherwise, this is another bottle. So I don't have a bottle, that's why. See, there's a two bottle in my hand. The left side is the p-value. The right side is my significant value. Otherwise, you can treat it. This is a significant value. So what is my significant value? 0.05. The right side is the p-value. Kindly treat it like this. The right side is the p-value. The left side, what is the left side?
Significance value.
Yeah. Otherwise, normally we are writing p is the left side, no? So therefore, I'm keeping like this. Otherwise, you may confuse like this. Now, see here, this is my significant 0.05. The right side is a 0.05 level. I'm taking like 500 ml. The left side, the p-value. Now, see here, this is also bottle, very small bottle. I'm keeping small bottle like this. Can I pour the entire water in this bottle? If a bottle in the sense, can I pour the entire water in this bottle?
Yes.
What it means? Then my p-value is less than. My p-value. Therefore, I am able to pour it. Therefore, it's significant. So I am significantly transferring my p-value to here. Therefore, significant. You got clear. Significant represent what? In the case of the null hypothesis, we are using not significant. Alternate hypothesis, we are keeping significant. Therefore, what it means? Significant means null hypothesis rejected. You got clear, right? Next, I am keeping this in another bottle. For example, I am keeping this in bottle. This here, this is my p-value. This is my significant value. What is my significant value?
0.05.
So I am going to pour the water. So is it possible? This is size?
No. Not possible.
What is mean? What it means?
Not significant.
Yeah. So I am not able to pour the entire water. Therefore, it's called not significant. I am not able to transfer the entire water into this bottle because this capacity only 500 ml. I cannot put in the 1 liter water bottle into here. Therefore, the p-value is greater than 0.05. It is called.
Not acceptable.
Anyone can type in the chat box what I am going to tell. P-value. Now the p-value in the left side. I am going to pour it. So anyone can type p. So you can type like this. P greater than. Please, anyone can type the chat box. P greater than. P greater than anyone. P greater than 0.05. What it means? What it means? Not significant. Exactly. Not significant. Not significant means what? What significant means what? Null hypothesis. Null hypothesis.
Accepted.
So yesterday, Sartono, you don't use the word accepted. It's better you can not
rejected. Sorry.
Not rejected. Okay, exactly. Now you got clear. If p value greater than 0.05 is called, you can instead of a null hypothesis rejected, accepted, better you can check first significant or not significant. From the significant or not significant, you can check whether the null hypothesis is rejected or not rejected. So very simple. Now the p value is greater than 0.05, not significant. Not significant represent null hypothesis. We cannot be remove it. We cannot be reject it. Right? Suppose see this case. P see they both is same. Both is same size. Suppose p value 0.05. This bottle also 0.05. Okay. Can I pour this same bottle? So please kindly imagine the p value 0.05. Highly the 500 liter water bottle at the left side. Right side and the 500 water bottle. Can I pour it?
Yes.
Yeah, if p value is 0.05, what? Anyone can tell? P equal to, anyone can type in the chat box, if p equal to 0.05. If p value is 0.05, what it happen? Is it significant or not significant? I'm able to significantly pour it, no? Therefore, what it means? Significant. Significant means what? Whether the null hypothesis was accepted or rejected. So, rejected or not rejected? Not rejected.
Not rejected.
Exactly. Not rejected. So no.
Rejected.
Yeah. Rejected. Please kindly see. Significant represent alternate hypothesis. Not significant represent null hypothesis. You got clear? Yes. Now yes. The first one. Now the p value is very small. Significant is 0.05. So you can type people in the chat box. if p value less than 0.05, anyone can type p less than 0.05? Whether can I pour it? Can I pour the entire water? No, kindly see, if p value is 0.0, my p value is this much only, okay, like there is 0.02 only. Can I pour the entire only 250 ml this one? Can I pour the entire water here?
Yes, sir.
It's possible. Therefore, what it means, it's significant or not significant?
Significant.
Significant. Significant means what? Significant means what?
Significant, null hypothesis rejected.
Yeah, exactly. Now this only the things, kindly see, if p less than or equal to, please kindly note your mind, if p less than or equal to level of significance 0.05 level or 0.01 level, what it means, it is any idea whether it is
significant.
Exactly. So before going for the conclusion about the hypothesis, first you can check whether it's significant or not significant. Then you can easily find. Okay. If p greater than 0.05, what it happened? You cannot be pour the entire water.
Not
therefore,
significant.
Not significant. Not significant.
Null hypothesis.
Yeah, because not significant means it's like both the groups are same. That's very simple. I hope now you are getting some idea the exact meaning of the P. Okay, P is represent here probability. Yes, now I'm moving to the so in this case, what did happen then? Can you see what did happen in this t-test? So in this test, what did happen? What did happen? Here the p value, the p value less than, okay, p value less than 0.03, okay, so 0.05, therefore it's called significant. Significant means null hypothesis rejected. Okay, that's what is the finding. There is a significant difference between male and female in the achievement scores. You got clear? So in this group, which group is high? The mean score?
Significant.
Which group is good? Which group's mean score is high? Male or female?
Female.
Therefore, what's the conclusion? You are telling the significant, but you have to give the proper interpretation. So here in this case, females mean score are better than the male female scores. Either you have to give some explanation. Okay.